Hi, Saviors, GH here. Today, we're gonna be doing official guide, and we're gonna start by introducing her, what she is, then her abilities, what she can do, then recommended weapons, artifact sets, and main stat and sub stat that you're gonna be looking for. And with that said, let's do this! Okay, Fischl. She's an electro weak point attacker support that uses bows. And what I mean by support is, she's an elemental marker. Her job is to mark the enemy with electro. And on occasions, exploit weak points. She's accompanied by a raven named Oz, and she can only be obtained through gacha or events. Her talents or abilities are as follows. First is Bolts of Downfall. It's your basic attack. You can use it to charge up bow attacks and inflict electro damage to enemies. This is not a priority in terms of leveling up your talents. Second talent is Knight Rider. This is the Raven summoning skill that continually deal electro type damage to enemies. You can increase the damage of this skill by getting more attack or using an artifact set that increases electro type damage or elemental skill damage. And for additional information, that Knight Rider electro bird that keeps attacking is Fischl. What I mean by that is, even if Fischl is not on the battlefield, the stats of Fischl will apply to that Knight Rider. The reason I'm saying this is, there will be occasions that the Knight Rider skill will trigger an elemental reaction. And even if Fischl is not on the battlefield and the Knight Rider triggers an elemental reaction, the damage will be based off Fischl's elemental mastery when the Knight Rider triggers an elemental reaction. Here is an example. As you can see, the enemy is marked with Cryo. And when the Knight Rider attacks the Cryo marked enemy, the elemental reaction will be based off Fischl's elemental mastery, even if Fischl is not on the battlefield. Treat that Knight Rider Raven as Fischl herself. Okay, what I just explained there happens occasionally, but usually that Knight Rider Raven is the one that marks the enemy with electro, and the one currently in the battlefield is the one that triggers the elemental reaction. So focusing on Fischl's attack stat and additional electro damage bonus should be a priority most of the time, except if you have a character that can mark the enemy with another element faster, like for example mages like Barbara, Mona, and a few others. Next talent is Midnight Phantasmagoria. It's her elemental burst, and what it does is turn Fischl into a raven that deals electro type damage to enemies in her path. And at the end of the duration, she will summon the raven again. The main use of this skill is not to damage enemies, and it's to summon the Knight Rider Raven again. It's another way to summon back the Knight Rider skill, which is very handy because the cooldown of the Knight Rider skill is very long. And with the use of Midnight Phantasmagoria, you can summon the Knight Rider one more time. That's its main use. As a secondary way to summon Oz or the Knight Rider. Next talent is Stellar Predator. And to put it simply, this talent amplifies Fischl's charge attack when you use your charge attack on the Raven. So what happens there is, when you attack the Raven then shoots an amplified attack on its current target. Here is an example. As you can see, when I shoot the Raven with a charge attack, the Raven then inflicts an additional damage, which is an amplified damage of Fischl's charge attack. Is this useful? In my playstyle, it's not, because I only use Fischl to summon the Raven and then I switch back to my main DPS. That is the best way to use Fischl as a support and weak point attacker. The final talent that we're gonna be looking at is the Lightning Smite. And what it does is, every time the Raven Oz is in the battlefield and you trigger an electro-related elemental reaction like Superconduct, the enemy will receive extra damage, which is 80% of Fischl's attack. Remember, the Raven must be present to get this extra damage. Those are the skills. If you have any more questions, please ask in the comment section down below. Okay, next is Fischl's recommended weapon. And I repeat, these are the weapons that I recommend. For the pay-to-win option, the 5-star weapon is both the Amos Bow and Skyward Harp. because both of them, in a way, increases your elemental abilities. Like for example, the Amos Poe has an attack substat, which will directly increase both your elemental skill and elemental burst. For the Skyward Harp, it has a substat of crit, which also applies to your Night Raven and Phantasmagoria. And the effect even increases crit damage. So both Amos Bow and Skyward Harp will be great. For the pay-to-win 4-star weapons, the bow that I recommend is Rust, the Stringless, and the Royal Bow. Let's explain why the Rust. The only reason I recommend it is the substat is attack. And in my opinion, the attack stat is Fischl's main stat. That's it. I don't like the weapon effect because you won't use basic attack that much on Fischl. Because Fischl is only used to attack weak points and mark enemies with Electro. Now for the Stringless. I recommend this because of its weapon effect, which increases elemental skill and elemental burst damage. The elemental mastery substat is just a bonus. And for the Royal Bow, again, I recommend it because of the substat, its attack. That's it. Now, for the free-to-play recommended bow for Fischl, and its prototype Crescent, because the substat is attack, and when on occasion that you exploit an enemy weak point, you get increased attack. Another good thing about that prototype Crescent is you can further refine it to get it to its full potential without gambling. You can just farm the materials and refine to your heart's content. Now, I know you're gonna ask, why not compound bow? It's because that bow is for main DPS bow types only. And I tell you, Fischl is not a main DPS. Therefore, I do not recommend a compound bow. But if you like Fischl as a main DPS, then a compound bow is an option. And to make it simple and easily understandable, here is my recommended bow tier list. And the rank 1 is the best. And at rank 1, it's the Stringless. At rank 2, is the Skyward Harp. At rank 3, it's the Amos Bow. Actually, the Amos Bow and Skyward Harp is kinda tied, so any of both. At rank 4, the Royal Bow. At rank 5, the Prototype Crescent. At rank 6, is Rust. Now that we got the weapon recommendations out of the way, now let's start with the artifact sets. And before we start, I just wanna say that I will be doing a recommendation for Fischl that is a main DPS, just in case somebody is here that is very into Fischl, that they want Fischl to be the main DPS. And I must reiterate, I do not recommend Fischl as a main DPS. She's a support, but of course, you do what you want, right? That's why we're gonna do a separate main DPS artifact set recommendation. Let's start with the artifact set that works with both main DPS and support. And if you're still early in your adventure rank, the artifact set that I recommend is an instructor set, a berserker set, or a martial artist set. And you're probably thinking, you're saying that this is a support artifact set. So why berserker? The reason is, crit rate also works on the Knight Rider elemental skill, even if Fischl is not on the battlefield. As I've said, treat that Knight Rider Raven, that bird, as Fischl. And of course, there are more sets that works well early in the game. But it's not that important. You can slap any artifact on Fischl early in the game, and it should work. The important stage of your adventure rank is when you reach adventure rank 35+. And when your adventure rank is 35+, the artifact that I recommend that works for main DPS and support is the Thundering Fury set. This will increase your electro damage and elemental reaction related to electro. And then Noblesse Oblige. It will work with both support and main DPS because it increases burst damage and increases the whole party's attack after using an elemental burst. You can also use 2 pieces of Gladiator set and 2 pieces of Thundering Fury to further increase the damage of your Knight Rider. Now, when your adventure rank 35+ and your Fischl is your main DPS, the only artifact set that I recommend to you is the Wanderer's Trope, because 4 pieces of it can increase the damage of your charge attacks. Now, for the main stats and substats that you're gonna be looking for in your artifacts, let's start with the substats. And this works with both main DPS and support type Fischl. You're gonna be looking for attack percent, attack stat, crit rate, and crit damage. Any combination of those. You can also include elemental mastery. And guys, don't be a perfectionist because you will be disappointed. Okay, for the main stats of your artifacts, always go for attack and electro damage bonus. And you can only get electro damage bonus on the goblets artifact. This one. I think I should say that the Flower of Life's main stat is always HP, so you can't get attack there, just in case you're wondering. Just make sure your Flower of Life has a good set of substat. Now, opinion time. To me, Fischl is one of the best character in the game. She is very useful, she can be used to exploit enemy weakness, and she can also be used to continually mark enemies with Electro. The ability to attack weak points and continually marking enemies with Electro is what makes her a great character. And that's it guys, my official guide. If you have any more questions, just comment down below. And if you like the video, hit the like button, share, and then subscribe to be part of the Gaming Hardcore family. And as always, this is Gaming Hardcore. See you in the next one.